Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We bless your holy name, Jesus. We bless your name, Lord. Jesus, we welcome you, Lord, in this place.
Amen.
Thank you for coming today, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. We really appreciate your presence, Lord Jesus. We appreciate, Lord, your presence. We love your presence, Lord, with your spirit. We love the presence of the Holy Spirit. We enjoy it, Lord. We love it. We enjoy it, Lord. Thank you for the anointing, Lord. Thank you for the mighty anointing, Lord. Lord, thank you, thank you, thank you, God, for always visiting us, O Lord, in our every service, Lord Jesus. You are a million times welcome, Lord Jesus, because it is you, O God, whom we worship, O God, and none else, O Lord. Lord, thank you, all the glory, honor, praises, worship, thanksgiving, O Lord. We give all to you, Lord Jesus, because you alone are worthy to be thanked and praised. You are holy, holy, holy God Almighty, we declare it, Lord. We declare it, Lord. You are the only holy, 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 mighty God.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Lord, we commit our service into your hands today. Bless your people. Open their hearts. Open their minds. Help them, Lord, to receive the revelation from heaven. And help them, Lord, to live according to your word, O God. According to what they will hear today, tonight, O God. Help all of us, O Lord, to walk in the light of your revelation. Lord, thank you so much. Thank you so much in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. Everybody say,
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Praise God. Hallelujah. Human beings are created to worship.
Amen.
So, when Friday comes, we need to come to the church and put it in your mind, I am coming to the church to worship. Because if you don't worship Jesus, if you don't worship the true living God, your soul, your spirit, your body, your mind will find another thing to worship. Will find another thing to worship. So it is very important to have a mindset. To have our mindset that we will come to the church to worship. To worship. Otherwise, your body, your mind, your soul, your spirit will find something else to worship. Could be a gadget, could be a car, could be money, could be profession, anything. Your body, your spirit, soul, and body will always look for something to worship. That's the reason why it is very important to put, to have a mindset that we will come to the church, I'm going to come to the church to worship. To worship. This is the reason why so many people are astray. They come everywhere. They go everywhere. They look for something else that could satisfy their emotions, their soul, their desires. And then later on, they come to a point where they worship those things. Some people worship their cars, not knowing that they're worshiping their cars only. Put so many decorations on the wheels, on the steering wheels. Lagyan ng buntot. Everything. Why? Because their whole being is looking for something to worship. And then they look at their car. Beautiful. Beautiful. How can I make you more beautiful? Are we getting this? Why? Because our whole being is always want to worship something. Bible says God put a vacuum in our hearts. And that vacuum cannot be filled by material things or anything or any other else except by the presence of God.
Amen.
And this vacuum in our heart is always looking for something to fill that vacuum. To fill it. Others are indulged in travel. To fill that vacuum. I'm still empty. I need to buy a nice car. I'm still empty. Maybe if I can buy a better car, still empty. Maybe I need to build a nice house. The house is built, still empty. What's lacking? What's lacking with me? The thing that is lacking on you is the presence of God. If you have God, if you have Jesus and the Holy Spirit in your heart, you will be fully satisfied.
Yes.
I'm satisfied with my car. I'm satisfied with my house. I'm satisfied with my wealth. I'm satisfied with my wife, with my husband.
Amen.
You will be satisfied.
Amen.
You know the reason why there's so many sexual immoral relationships? They are not satisfied with what they have. They're looking for something, somebody, to fill the vacuum in their hearts. And so they would say, oh, that girl is more beautiful than my wife. That man is more charming than my husband. No. You are deceived. That vacuum in our heart can never be satisfied by anybody or anything.
Amen.
Except by God. Palapakan po natin ang Panginoon. This is the reason why we need to worship the right person.
Amen.
Otherwise, you'll be worshiping the wrong person. We need to worship the right person. And that person is Jesus the Christ.
Amen.
The Son of the living God. Give Him praise. Give Him praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Revelation, oh God, that you have given us, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. You come to the church, you learn many things.
Amen.
You become wise. You become wise, therefore, you prosper.
Amen.
You don't make wrong decision. We make good choices. Everything in our life, it's a choice. You are the result of your choices. And this is our topic for tonight. How to make good choices. There's so many persons who makes wrong choices every day. So their lives are miserable. Miserable. Why? Wrong choice. Wrong decision. Why did I end up choosing the wrong thing? No wisdom. No basis. No Word of God. The Word of God is the wisdom of God. And it brings benefit to everyone who will receive it. It brings benefit. It brings life. Good life. Health, healing, strength, abundance, prosperity. It is written in the book of Proverbs.
Amen.
Wisdom brings all good things in the lives of people. When you come to the church, you receive the wisdom of God. Now, it is still your choice to follow, to obey, or to disobey the wisdom of God that you have already in your hearts and in your mind. Obedience to the Word of God is the key to total satisfaction, total victory, abundance, prosperity in our lives. My son, be attentive to my words. Incline your ear to my sayings. That you may keep discretion and your lips may guard knowledge. We are being commanded by God to incline our ears, meaning to listen attentively. To listen without distraction. What are the distractions? You're in the church, you're thinking about your mind is somewhere else. That is distraction. You are distracted by those thinking, by those thoughts. And the Bible says, be attentive. Tell your neighbor, be attentive tonight.
Be attentive tonight. Be attentive tonight.
No distraction. Leave all your problems behind. Jesus will take care of your problems.
Amen.
Amen. Leave all those cares, all those challenges behind. When you are in the church, give your 100% attention to Jesus.
Amen.
To the Word of God, to the Holy Spirit. And it is for your benefit.
Amen.
It is for your benefit. So we incline.
Amen.
You're leaning to Jesus.
Amen.
We incline our ears to the Word of God. Amen.
Amen.
Let's go to Joshua chapter 24, verse 15. Joshua fought so many battles. He conquered 31 kingdoms. Can you imagine that? Without losing a single battle. I've told you before, he's the best general who ever lived. Abu Sayyaf, nothing. ISIS, nothing. Let's give this terrorist to Joshua. He will wipe them out.
Amen.
He will wipe them out. Abu Sayyaf, 200 people, he could not catch them. They could not catch them, and they keep on taking hostages. He gave that to Joshua. Joshua will wipe them out. He didn't lose any battle. He conquered 31 kings and kingdoms. He destroyed all of them. And others were giants in Hebron and in other places, the Amalekites, the Anaks. They were all giants. You know how big they were? 9 foot tall. Not 7 foot. Have you seen a 7-footer basketball player?
Amen.
So tall. Add 2 feet to that person. They're really big. But Joshua, he conquered all these enemies. Why? Because he made the right choice.
Amen.
To be with God, to be on the side of God.
Amen.
Making right choices will give you victory.
Amen. Amen.
Choose to come to the church every week.
Amen.
Choose to read your Bible every day.
Amen.
Choose to pray every day.
Amen.
Every moment.
Amen.
Anywhere you are.
Amen.
You can pray.
Amen.
These are all choices that we have to make every day. But we must make the right choices every day. Let's read. Joshua is something like 110 years old already. He's going to die. He's old already. He fought all the battles victoriously. Now, he is admonishing the Israelites because he's going to die already. He's very old. So he said, and if it is evil in your eyes to serve the Lord, or if you are reluctant to serve the Lord, you are not willing to serve the Lord, because, you know, these people he's been trying to bring to the promised land has been on and off, and on and off to God. Today, Jesus, I love you, Jesus. I don't want to come to the church now. Jesus, Jesus, I love you, Jesus. I don't feel coming to the church today. Don't call me, okay? We're going to pick you up, please, we will. I'm not going to the church today. Joshua says, if it is evil in your eyes or you are reluctant, my Bible. To serve the Lord, choose this day whom you will serve. Joshua says, you make a decision today. Amen. The devil or Jesus, righteousness or evil, light or darkness. There is no sway here. There is no sway. Are we getting
it? Amen.
Amen.
There is no 50-50. If you want to serve God, then you serve God.
Amen.
Halas, finish.
Amen.
You don't want to serve God, serve the devil. And go to hell. Choose this day whom you will serve. Joshua is telling us, make your choice. It's a choice. Make your choice. Are you going to serve God or not? Ask your neighbor. Make your choice. Are you going to serve God or not? Don't tell your neighbor.
Amen.
Amen.
Walang 50-50 sa Panginoon.
Amen.
You serve God well.
Amen.
Eh, 50-50 ba sa mag-asawa? Ay, mahal kita ngayon. Bukas, ayaw ko. I love you 50%. Hello, you love me 50%? What will you do? Iwalay. Halas, you're dead. Ikaw, what will you do? 50% I love you.
No.
Yeah, yeah.
No, amen.
Yes.
You hear that? Ikaw, pastor ka. 100%. You hear that? Amen. It's the same with the Lord!
Amen!
No 50-50, no lukewarmness!
Amen.
We must be on fire. Hallelujah. Always on fire. Always on fire. We go forward. We go forward. We go forward. Always on fire. Always on fire. No laziness.
Amen.
Always excited for the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Choose this day whom you will serve. Whether the gods of your fathers serve in the region beyond the river, who are those gods? The gods of the Amorites, the idols. Now, these idols is just a representation of many things. What is the idol in your life? You have so many idols. You idolize yourself. Amen? We idolize our properties, our car, our house. You idolize your job, your profession. You worship money. Always money. I want to work overtime. May overtime now, may part-time pa. Overtime. Tapos overtime, part-time. No more time for the Lord. This is another form of God. You are worshiping something except God. This is idolatry, by the way.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters. You work too much, you are an idolater.
Amen.
We need to rest one day.
Amen.
6 days, yes. Sobra na 6 days. Ako nga, 5 days lang. Parang sobrang pa eh. We want to serve the Lord more.
Amen.
And yet here, some people, they work 7 days a week, 16 hours a day in America. I want a bigger television. Ang laki-laki na nga, hindi pa makita yung tao. I want a larger one. A larger one, a bigger one. Are you blind? I want a big house. Wala naman nakatira. Nobody's dwelling. want a nice car. How many cars do you need? In America, you don't have 2 cars or 3 cars. You're not at par. You know, there's plenty of Filipinos there. Tatlo na kotse, kulang pa. Otherwise, ito'y ginagamit talaga, pero mag-isa ka lang, you're alone. This is another form of God. And Joshua says, choose today whom you will serve. God in your life or the material things? The material things. Materialism is evil. Materialism is evil. This is the reason why the politicians. I need more millions, Raymond. More millions, more millions. E sino ko kontakin natin dyan? I know somebody na police. She knows how to do this. She knows how to do this. There are multi-millionaires already. They have mansions in Forbes Park. And still, they need more money. If the money is earned legally, fine. But if you're stealing the money, you are evil.
Amen.
This is evil. And God will punish all those people forever.
Amen.
We'll read the verse a little bit later. I'm going to show it to you. But Joshua is telling us, if you want to serve God, you serve God. Khalas, finish. But as for me and my family, we will serve the Lord.
Amen.
Anong parang ko na? As for me and my household, Joshua says, whatever you want, whatever is your decision, I don't care. You worship those gods, you worship this god, you worship materialism, but praise God, as for me and my household, we will serve the living God. Hallelujah. We will serve the living God. So he says, but as for me and my household, we will serve the Lord.
Amen.
He made a decision. He made the choice. He chose to serve the Lord. Whom will you choose? Whom will you choose? I'm going to repeat to you. Your spirit, soul, and body will find something to worship if you don't worship God.
Amen.
You are inclined always to worship something or somebody. That's why if you don't go to the church, you are on vacation, your body will start to find something to worship. Kaya yung iba sa atin, nalalamig when they come to the church because they didn't worship the Lord, very weak sila. They are very weak spiritually. Why? They didn't worship the Lord during their vacation. They didn't go to the church. So, your spirit, soul, and body will try to find something to worship. O nakababad ka ngayon sa computer, nakababad ka sa internet, nakababad ka sa Facebook. Why? Because your whole being is trying to find something to worship. Yes. We need to discipline ourselves, our minds, and have a mindset that I will worship God every Friday or every Sunday when I'm on vacation.
Amen.
Mindset. Why? Your body will try to find something to worship. Amen?
Amen.
Let's go to the book of Colossians. Colossians chapter 1, verse 22 to 23. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Colossians chapter 1, verse 23 up to 24. Let us read. Start reading on verse 21. Once you were alienated from God and were enemies in your minds because of your evil behavior. 22, but now He has reconciled you by Christ's physical body through death to present you holy in His sight without blemish and free from accusation. If you continue in your faith, established and firm, not moved from hope held out in the gospel. The Bible says, we will maintain our salvation. We will maintain the benefits of what Jesus did on the cross. If we continue in our faith, kung tayo ay magpapatuloy sa ating pananampalataya, what Jesus did on the cross will have an effect in your life. What Jesus did on the cross has plenty of effects in our lives. He saved our souls from hell. He forgave our sins. He redeemed us from the curse of the law, from the curse of sickness and diseases and poverty. And many, many more. And Apostle Paul says, all these things will continue to be manifesting in your life if you continue in your faith. And steadfast, we continue in our faith in serving the Lord. And steadfast means firm.
Amen.
Steadfast. Hindi ako matitinag na aking problema.
Amen.
I'm firm. I'm steadfast.
Amen.
Amen.
Bakit maapektuhan ang faith mo ng problem? Why? What's the reason for that? There's no reason for that. Whatever you believe, you believe.
Amen.
Why should the problem affect your faith? It has nothing to do at all on your faith. Ito hindi maintindihan ng maraming tao. Many people don't understand this. When they have problems, their faith are affected, which shouldn't be.
Amen.
Kasi your faith is your faith.
Amen.
You believe in Jesus Christ? Yes, we believe in Jesus Christ. Kalas, finish, it's done. You're firm. Not shifting. Some people are shifty. You know what shifting is? Palipat-lipat ng pag-iisip. Pabago-bago ng pag-iisip, pabago-bago ng desisyon. They're changing their decision, their choices. Ngayon, matibay, malakas. A little bit later, mahina. Excited! Melancholic. Malungkot. Let's go to the church! Yes, I want to go to the church. Let's go to the church! I don't like. I don't like to go to the church. Shifty! The Bible says, let's not be shifty. Shifting from the hope of the gospel that you heard. You've just been proclaiming all creation under heaven, of which I, Paul, became a minister. Paul was a minister of the gospel. He proclaimed the gospel. He preached the gospel. And he's admonishing the people to be steadfast or to be firm in their faith. Continue in our faith. Continue in our faith and be firm. Be steadfast, be strong, like a rock.
Amen.
And not shifty. You know the trees when it's windy,